And we are back. Welcome to the semifinals for the Contest of Champions. Yep, that's right. We're back. This is the semifinal round. So, last round was the other semifinal, but we're going to have this semifinal where basically the top 10 will be in the next round. Yeah, I know 10 plus 10 is 20, and there are 12 districts, so that means there's going to be four other people. Those will be our special boss guests. They'll be like the boss battle guys, I guess. They're gonna be like the special guests. They don't have to do the semifinal to get onto the, you know, championship round. They're just that good. So yeah, let's go ahead and run through the roster here. In District 1, it's Toucan Sam and Lucky the Leprechaun. This is the cereal-themed district. Hopefully they'll be able to put on a good show. I know Lucky the Leprechaun, he is actually mentally insane. He actually escaped an insane asylum. Yeah, he's mentally insane. Toucan Sam. You know, he's going to perform well. In District 2, we have Tom Nook. And is that my wallet? That's my wallet! Tom Nook! If any of you haven't played Animal Crossing, Tom Nook, of course, is the IRS of Animal Crossing, basically, and it appears he has teamed up with my wallet. He has stolen my wallet. So, Tom Nook and my wallet from District 2. In District 3, we have an ironic duo featuring Aquaman and Sandman. I don't know how these guys are going to perform together. They're probably not going to do very well. Aquaman, what is he going to do? And then Sandman, these guys are just useless. Unless they're by, like, water or sand, they're just useless. These guys are only effective if they're, like, near the beach. That's it. Okay, that is all. If you fight these guys anywhere else, you're probably going to have, like, a good chance of winning. I don't think Aquaman and Sandman are going to do very well. I don't. I know they're superheroes, but, I mean, look, I'm just looking at Tom Nook right there. He's probably got the upper hand, you know? He could just bribe them to, you know, leave, because he's got all that money. My money. I almost want to disqualify him for that. In District 4, we have my least favorite district. It is NNA Productions and his subscriber. If you don't know who NNA Productions is, don't look him up. I mean, unless you want to. I can't stop you. I don't want to you know, send people over there to bully his channel or anything. Because it's his content, he can do what he wants. But I've never met a more annoying YouTuber on the platform. This guy's probably one of the more annoying YouTubers on the platform. He does the Ben 10 3 a.m. like Happy Meal challenge stuff. But yeah, he's here. We'll see how he fares against all these other opponents, like District 5. I don't think he's gonna do very well against District 5. It's Hernan Cortez and Captain Barbosa. If you haven't seen the Pirates of the Caribbean movie, Captain Barbosa kind of references Hernan Cortez's like lust for gold. I mean, they're not the only person who's obsessed with gold on this list, but we'll get to him later. In District 6, it is the Penguins of Madagascar and Piplup, the Pokemon. Again, I don't think you're allowed to enter multiple participants, but George Washington and his horde of Minutemen did it, so I don't see why they can't do it themselves. District 7, we have Marge Simpson and Knuckles. I don't know how these guys are going to do together. I really don't. You know, hopefully they get along pretty well. You know, I don't know. Marge Simpson, hopefully she's ready for a good challenge, because there are a lot of good opponents in today's matchup. Like, wait a minute. Is that Dick Dastardly? He got eliminated last round. He's not supposed to be here. Who let him in? Who let Dick Dastardly in? He is not supposed to be in this tournament. He got eliminated last round. He's not supposed to be here. The last semifinals round, he was eliminated. He's supposed to be gone. Who let him in this tournament? It appears that Dick Dastardly will be competing in today's tournament. His teammate will be Buzz from Cyber Chase. I hope they lose. I really do. Dick Dastardly is a cheater, and Buzz is... Whatever, man. Whatever. If they're gonna let Dick Dastardly compete twice, then so be it, okay? He's gonna lose again anyways. It doesn't even matter. In District 9, it's... Oh, gosh. Lil Sweet. It is Lil Sweet. Lil Sweet? Whatever, however you'd want me to pronounce his name. He's the guy from the Diet Dr. Pepper commercials. He is teaming up with Winston from Overwatch. Again, really unlikely duo. I would not have guessed that they would be teaming up, but they are. And hopefully they will perform well. I think they will. I think Little Sweet and Winston, they're kind of like the underdogs of this tournament. People kind of underestimate them, but I think they're going to do pretty well today. I really do. And in District 10, one of the highest seeded districts, it is District 10 Amenhotep III, teaming up with Midas Man from Fortnite. That's right, Midas from Fortnite is here. If you heard me reference Hernan Cortez earlier in his lust for gold, hopefully Midas does not die at his hands, because I guarantee you Hernan Cortez, the second he sees a man made, literally a man made out of gold, he sees this guy, he's going to go ballistic. But anyways, they're going to be teaming up today, and District 10 should be, you know, I can see them going all the way. They are a top seed to win this tournament. And in District 11, it is Manny from Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. He's the camera guy from Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. And Papa Smurf. I don't expect much from these guys. They're both small. You can both curb stomp both of them. Like, just punt them like a football. They're both really short. Papa Smurf, I don't know. A lot of people underestimate their power, I feel like. Myself included. I don't think they're going to get very far. But you know what? Maybe Papa Smurf could prove me wrong. He's kind of got that Lucky the Leprechaun feel for me, honestly. Like, he just got out of an insane asylum. And our final district, District 12, it is Jack Nicholson teaming up with Quagmire. They'll be making up District 12. I think Quagmire is, he's going to kind of carry this district. Jack Nicholson, a little older. He's starting to lose his touch on the battlefield. But, you know, Quagmire's that young, hip talent that I think, you know, he'll bring some life to this district. So, I can see them going all the way. Maybe, like, a later seed. Like, maybe, like, I can see him going top 10, but I can't see him going, like, top 5. They'll be, like, at 7 or 8. And remember, it can't just be, like, one person from one district allows them to go to the championship. Like, no. These guys on the districts, they don't even have to be teammates. They don't even have to team up with each other. They could probably just backstab each other. That's what Michelle Obama did last round. She betrayed her own husband. Barack Obama was betrayed last round by Michelle Obama. Hopefully, we will have a good matchup today. Let us begin the first annual Contest of Champions, the second semifinal round. This will take us to the championship match. Whoever wins today in the top 10 will be going on to the championship. It begins with the Penguins of Madagascar running away from the cornucopia. Dick Dastardly, Lucky the Leprechaun, and Little Sweet all do the same. Papa Smurf breaks Winston's nose for a basket of bread. Papa Smurf breaks Winston's nose for a basket of bread. A basket of bread. I knew Papa Smurf. You know what? I had that vibe. I came into this underestimating his abilities, and now he just broke Winston's nose. This guy is insane. Papa Smurf is probably more insane than Lucky the Leprechaun is. My Wallet defeats Amenhotep III in a fight but spares his life. My Wallet almost killed Amenhotep III, a top seed, a top seeded player today. My Wallet might regret doing that. He might regret, you know, My Wallet might just regret sparing his life. I wouldn't have spared his life. I would have killed him because he is that big of a competitor. But Amenhotep will stay alive. That goes for Piplup as well. Midas defeats Piplup in a fight but spares his life. Quagmire, Knuckles, Jack Nicholson, and Manny raid NNA Productions camp while he is hunting. Oh, Hernan Cortez bashes the Penguins of Madagascar's head against a rock several times. He bashes all four of their heads against a rock? Does that mean they're dead? Gosh. A fire spreads throughout the arena, and the fire catches up to Dick Dastardly, killing him. Dick Dastardly is the first to fall here. You know how in basketball they say ball don't lie? Well, here in the Contest of Champions semifinal round, contest don't lie. You're out, Dick Dastardly. Enough is enough from you. That is blatant cheating what he did. He should have been eliminated. He should not be participating, so he will not be moving on to the Contest of Champions championship. He will be done. He is out. He got a second chance and he blew it. NNA subscriber survives. Hernan Cortez survives. A fireball strikes Toucan Sam, killing him. That is two deaths from this forest fire, or whatever fire is spreading through the arena. It's killed quite a lot of people. A fireball strikes Lucky the Leprechaun, killing him. District 1 has been eliminated, both by fireballs. Incredible. Fireballs are really claiming a lot of lives today. Manny falls to the ground, but kicks My Wallet hard enough to then push him into the fire. My Wallet is dead. It is burnt up. All the money inside is ruined, so thanks, Manny. I was kind of hoping he won today, because, you know, that means I get my wallet back. But, Buzz kills Tom Nook in order to utilize a body of water safely. So now District 2 has been eliminated. Tom Nook and My Wallet are eliminated. Serves Tom Nook right for stealing My Wallet. A fireball strikes Sandman, killing him. Captain Barbossa gets caught in the fire. This is insanity. There are people dying left and right. I thought day one was going to be a peaceful day, and then this fire comes out of nowhere. It has claimed so many lives. This being Captain Barbossa, he will not be moving on.
Then, everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked.
Piplup falls to the ground, but kicks Marge Simpson hard enough to then push her into the fire. So Marge Simpson is dead. 9 cannon shots can be heard in the distance. That is, of course, to honor all of our fallen tributes. Except for Dick Dastardly, who, of course, was not the first to fall, but the second to fall. The Penguins of Madagascar were the first to fall. Of course, getting their heads bashed by a rock. Jack Nicholson and Hernan Cortez talk about the tribute still alive, maybe exchanging some words of wisdom. Quagmire severely injures Papa Smurf and leaves him to die. That is an incredible kill by Quagmire. Of course, he has eliminated Papa Smurf, so both of the mentally insane tributes have passed away. Lucky the Leprechaun, of course, very insane, got struck by a fireball, and now Quagmire has killed Papa Smurf. Manny, Buzz, and Jack Nicholson, they actually accepted him. They might backstab him later on, though, so don't get comfortable with this group. Winston discovers a cave, and Quagmire chases Hernan Cortez. And, of course, the only person to fall on day one was, on day two, was Papa Smurf. Aquaman strangles Buzz after engaging in a fist fight. Aquaman strangled Buzz to death. I don't know how you strangle a guy who literally has no neck. He is just a ball with arms and legs. Amenhotep destroys Quagmire's supplies while he is asleep. Wow, that is unfortunate for Quagmire. He was seeing some early success, and now he is done. Hernan Cortez fends Jack Nicholson, NNA Productions, and Winston away from his fire. Of course, the only person who died on day three was Buzz. Of course, he was strangled to death, somehow. Quagmire goes to sleep. Hernan Cortez and Aquaman tell stories about themselves to each other. They both, of course, have had success exploring the open sea. Aquaman, of course, lives in the ocean, probably. And Hernan Cortez explored the ocean. Meet Os, Manny, NNA Productions, and Lil Sweet sleep in shifts. NNA Productions is just making friends left and right. He's just being Mr. Nice Guy, which is really surprising. It's almost as if he's hypnotized some of the other opponents. You know, maybe he gave him an Among Us potion at 3 a.m. Look, who knows? And Jack Nicholson and Knuckles hold hands. A love story that might just go on to the very end. It is now day four. We have not seen a lot of violence in the past few days. Hopefully we'll see some more action on day four. The past 2 days, there have only been a few tributes that have died. Hopefully we get a better look at some intense action. Maybe some more teaming up. Right now, it's just fighting for survival. Jack Nicholson overhears Hernan Cortez and Quagmire talking in the distance. Quagmire, of course, chased off Hernan Cortez previously, but it appears they've made amends. They're talking. Maybe they're gonna rekindle their relationship and team up again. Meanwhile, Midas forces Hernan Cortez to kill either Manny or Quagmire, and he decides to kill Manny. So it is official, Hernan Cortez and Quagmire have made amends. Midas, of course, calling the shots here. You'd think Hernan Cortez would have just, you know, destroyed Midas. He's made out of gold. Hernan Cortez loves gold. So we'll see. If Hernan Cortez kind of flips this thing around, but Quagmire and Hernan Cortez have sort of formulated like a best friend bond. Quagmire, of course, attempted to kill Hernan Cortez earlier around day two. Then they were caught talking. You know, Jack Nicholson caught him talking. They made amends. Hernan Cortez spares Quagmire and kills Manny. So Manny is eliminated. One cannon shot can be heard in the distance. Of course, day five, Manny was the first to fall. Amenhotep sets up camp for the night, and Piplup dies from hypothermia. How? Piplup dies from hypothermia. He's a literal penguin, so that's kind of hard to do. I don't know how he could have gotten hypothermia, but of course, Piplup, he is eliminated. NNA subscriber Amenhotep III and Winston track down and kill Little Sweet. Little Sweet, similarly to Piplup, has really not done anything wrong, but he gets eliminated. And towards the end of day 6, Jack Nicholson begs for Quagmire to kill him. Reluctantly, Quagmire does. And Jack Nicholson is eliminated, giving up early, couldn't handle the heat, too much expectations on his shoulders. And Jack Nicholson has been eliminated. So Quagmire, having to kill his own teammate, what a devastating loss for Quagmire, as, you know, him and Hernan Cortez still have that bond, but other than that, Quagmire might be alone after losing his teammate. Oh, gosh. Quagmire, you can't do this. Okay, Quagmire and NNA subscriber huddle for warmth. We'll just skim over that. Hernan Cortez stabs NNA Productions in the back with a trident. NNA Productions has been eliminated by Hernan Cortez, who is friends with Quagmire. Quagmire is currently cuddling with NNA subscriber, and Hernan Cortez kills NNA Productions, so that might mean NNA subscriber has beef with Quagmire for being friends with Hernan Cortez. Very, very complex situation here. Amenhotep kills Midas as he tries to run. These two were on the same team. Amenhotep III backstabs his teammate. There's a lot of backstabbing going on, literally and figuratively. Day 6, one of the more eventful days we've seen in the competition. That brings us to the feast. And before the feast occurs, Winston falls into a frozen lake and drowns. So Winston has been eliminated due to his clumsiness, and probably because he weighs too much to be standing on a frozen lake. Stupid. Hernan Cortez and Quagmire get into a fight over raw meat, but Hernan Cortez gives up and runs away, so Quagmire probably not really happy with Hernan Cortez again, as Hernan Cortez has broken his trust with Quagmire's trust ultimately, because Quagmire was huddling for warmth with NNA subscriber, probably got to know him pretty well, wakes up the next morning and finds out that NNA Productions has been murdered. This has been like a Quagmire arc, this whole thing. Very focused on Quagmire, which kind of draws our attention away from Amenhotep III, as he is tracked down and killed by NNA subscriber. Insane! NNA subscriber, of course, he is doing amazing. NNA Productions has died, Midas has died, Winston, and Amenhotep III, they have all been eliminated. But good news for them, they will be moving on to the championship round, so it's not all over yet. So night 7, Hernan Cortez and Quagmire fight NNA subscriber and Aquaman. NNA subscriber and Aquaman survive! And then NNA subscriber ambushes and kills Aquaman! This has been the most unlikely series of events. Quagmire and Hernan Cortez, they make amends in the very end, but it is not enough to trump Aquaman and NNA subscriber. But then NNA subscriber backstabs Aquaman in an ambush. That is insanity. That means NNA subscriber is the winner from District 4. Now, I said this at the beginning, that I doubted he would win. I thought he'd be one of the first to be eliminated. And he comes in, fights to the very end, and he wins it. NNA subscriber, my least favorite contestant next to NNA Productions, comes in here, and he wins. And he wins the semifinal, so he gets the semifinal trophy, he gets an honorable mention, sadly. And he is the winner in this round of the semifinals, so that brings us to the championship. We will see who is advanced. After we review how many kills there were, of course, we will move down the list. Penguins of Madagascar, of course, did the worst. And Buzz got a kill, Manny got a kill, Piplup surprisingly got a kill. Amenhotep III gets 2 kills. Hernan Cortez gets 3 kills, along with Quagmire's 3 kills. Aquaman gets 3 kills, and NNA subscriber goes on a rampage. Ruthless with those fidget spinners, he gets 5 kills. He killed 5 contestants. That's the most we've seen in Contest of Champions history. That is a new record. NNA subscriber gets 5 kills. What an impressive feat by him today. Or this week, rather, because it's been 8 very long days in this tournament. At number 1, of course, NNA subscriber, followed by Aquaman, Quagmire, Hernan Cortez, Amenhotep III, Winston, Midas, sadly NNA Productions, so the whole District 4 is coming back. Jack Nicholson makes it to the finals, and very unlikely, probably going to be an underdog moving into the championship round. It is Little Sweet. And Aquaman, another contestant. I did not see this coming. He doesn't get enough credit for making it all the way to second place. He's tied with Hernan Cortez and Quagmire for the most kills, second most kills. And You know, I said at the beginning of the match, for him as well, I don't think he's going to make it very far, and he did. He came out here, and he proved his worth. I am very taken back by Aquaman. Quagmire and Hernan Cortez's, you know, relationship carries on to the championship round. Hopefully it does. That was a very interesting story arc from them, but of course they didn't have enough to make it to first place. And Quagmire and Hernan Cortez fill out the 3 and 4 spots. So that will be the end of the semifinal round, and the championship is coming up, so we will see how this plays out. We're going to the championship here at the Contest of Champions.